If you're an adventurous person, you like to take risks. No challenge is too big or too small for you. Join me as we go through 14 more personality adjectives right now. Welcome back to my classroom, where I help you to build your confidence, boost your fluency, and bridge your world with the English language. My name is Dr. B, and I'll be your English teacher today. In today's lesson, we're looking at 15 adjectives that you can use to describe your personality. Be sure to stay until the very end because I'm going to share with you three tips for answering that interview question. What's your worst personality characteristic? So stay until the very end to get my tips. Our second personality adjective is bossy. Bossy is a negative personality trait. If you're a bossy person, you have particular ideas of how you want things to be done, and you're not shy about telling other people how to act or how to behave. Next, we have the personality characteristic cautious. Cautious is a neutral personality trait. If you're a cautious person, you think very hard before making any decisions. You don't like risks, and you're not very adventurous. Then we have creative. Creative is a positive personality characteristic. If you're a creative person, you might be very artistic, good at art, music, or design. Creative people often come up with very unique and good ideas. Our fifth personality characteristic is energetic. This is a positive personality characteristic. Someone who is energetic is always ready and fresh-faced, ready to take on any new challenge in front of them. Someone who is energetic would be very good for a fast-paced work environment. Then we have generous. Someone who is generous has a positive personality trait. They freely give their time, money, or energy to a task or person. And in many cases, a generous person will give more than what is expected. Next, we have hardworking. A person who is hardworking has a positive personality characteristic. A hardworking person will never leave a task or duty until it's done. It doesn't matter the time of day or night, they will finish their work before going to another activity. Our eighth personality characteristic is moody. Moody is a negative personality trait. If you're a moody person, one minute you're happy, and the next minute you might be angry or sad. You are not even-tempered. In fact, your personality changes from time to time, and people cannot predict how you act. Next, we have quiet. Quiet is considered a neutral personality trait. If you're a quiet person, you don't disturb other people. But on the other hand, you might be considered to be unfriendly because you keep to yourself and you don't often make noise or talk with others. Then we have reliable. Reliable is a positive personality trait. If you're a reliable person, people can trust in you. They know that if they have a problem, they can call on you and you will be there. A reliable person always finishes what they say they will do. Our 11th personality characteristic is sensible. Someone who is sensible is very logical and practical. While other people might dream of crazy things, someone who is sensible is always realistic about what can be done. Next, we have sensitive. Sensitive is a neutral personality trait. If someone is sensitive, they're easily emotional. For example, maybe they cry easily in movies or when they hear sad news. But on the other hand, someone who is sensitive can connect with their emotions and with other people's emotions. They can be very empathetic. Someone who is sensitive might be a great candidate for the HR department, the human resources department, because they know how to connect with how people are feeling. Our 13th personality characteristic is serious. This is a neutral personality characteristic. Someone who is serious doesn't like to make jokes or hear jokes. They don't like when people make light of serious or focused situations. They would rather focus on the task at hand. Then we have sociable. Sociable is a positive personality characteristic. Someone who is sociable is extroverted and friendly. They like to meet other people and talk with other people. That brings us to the 15th personality characteristic, which is thoughtful. Thoughtful is a positive personality trait. A thoughtful person thinks about other people and thinks about how their own actions might affect other people. A thoughtful person might be a great candidate for the human resources department. Now that we've covered the 15 different personality adjectives, I want to go through how to answer the interview question, what's your best and worst personality characteristic? As a manager, I've asked this question several times in interviews. The reason I ask this question is because it gives me a good insight into the candidate's personality. It also helps me to identify how this candidate might fit within the larger team. So my first tip here is to always answer the question. I've been in interviews where people say they don't have any positive personality characteristic. Well, that doesn't make you look very confident. And I've also been in interviews where people say they have no negative personality characteristic. Well, then you're not being very honest and you're not being realistic. Everyone has positive and negative traits. So answer the question. My second tip is to always try to spin a negative characteristic into a neutral or more positive way of looking at it. For example, if you're bossy, you might want to try saying that you're assertive and you're not stubborn, you're strong-willed. And maybe instead of saying that you're very talkative, say you're sociable. As you can see, by spinning these negative characteristics into something more positive, you'll leave a better impression on the manager. Finally, my third tip is to always start with the negative answer and move towards your positive answer. So first give your negative characteristic and then give your positive characteristic. You'll leave the manager with a better impression. They'll leave thinking about your positive trait and not your negative trait. Thank you for joining me in today's lesson on 15 different personality adjectives. If you got value out of this video, don't forget to hit that like button and drop me a comment as well. And you'll want to subscribe to my channel because in my next video, I'll be sharing 3 tips for speaking more fluently.